Hi, Alani. Thank you for doing this interview. And I was wondering if you could just quickly introduce yourself and what you're doing these days. And how many times have you studied the language schools and where? And when was your time in the German school?
Okay, sure. I'm Alani Hicks Bartlett. I attended the German school last year, so summer 2020. And I attended as a postdoc. And right now I'm assistant professor of French and Comp Lit at Brown University. And I have gone to the language schools, perhaps 11 or 12 times over the years. And this is my first time in the German school.
Oh, cool. So since you have had, you've taken so many language courses elsewhere, you've gotten your master's in French and you've studied and lived abroad. Why do you think attending the Middlebury language schools is the best way to learn a language?
I love the immersive environment. I really respect the language pledge, and I think all of the students always do too. And it's so cool to have, you know, a really intensive experience where everyone is working towards a common goal and everybody is really so excited about speaking the language and living in the language and doing whatever they can in the language. I also, you know, I really like traveling abroad for study programs and things of that nature, but I think sometimes, you know, people don't have a shared kind of goal to really make progress. Maybe people are traveling just for fun or just to experiment with the language. So I personally really have always loved the intensity of the language programs. And I couldn't have picked a better school and a better place to do that during so many summers.
Yeah, and is the language pledge, that must help too with learning the language.
Yeah, it's so great. I think it just sets it up so that from day one, people are doing as much as they can in the target language. I remember, you know, seeing the first level students who, I guess they have a kind of modified pledge. And it's just so great to see people who the first day don't know even a single word of German. And, you know, just to see then how much progress they're able to make in 6 weeks or 7 weeks I think the language pledge is really fantastic.
And since you're in a unique position, you've attended the language schools in person on campus, and this was the first time we've held them online. And did the program still meet your expectations?
Yes, the program completely surpassed my expectations. And I have to say that since I had gone to the language school so many times, and obviously I really love them, I had the absolute highest expectations already because I knew how great it had been in the past. And I learned just as much, if not more, even though it was slightly different, excuse me, not to be able to have the, you know, in-person interactions all of the time, but there were so many additional events that we were able to participate in. You know, I met offline with other students in my group and we always got together and spoke in German even outside of class. So there were just, it more than met my expectations in every way. And my classes were absolutely fantastic. So I didn't experience even the type of online Zoom fatigue and things like that, just because there was so much enthusiasm and so much excitement from the teachers themselves and from the other students. So it completely surpassed my very high expectations.
Great. And what do you think makes the German school in particular unique? And was there still a sense of community even though it was all online?
The German school was fantastic. And there was so I've always noticed on campus that the German school seems to be a very lively group, you know, with a lot of close relationships. I've always noticed things like, I think there are breakfast clubs and things like that. And it seems like a very robust, lively community. And that was definitely translated into the program online. We had lunch groups also. We had a lot of events. We had comics, comedians, academic programs, academic conferences. It was absolutely wonderful. And I think that kind of approach really creates a great sense of community. Students of all levels came to the lunch groups. People of all levels came to the academic conferences. And, you know, the kind of I guess, livelier events with the comedian and with the comic book illustrator and things of that nature. So it was just great to have those types of interactions too. And everybody is so excited about German. So the clubs, I mean, there was definitely a great sense of community, I thought.
Yeah, and you, I think you commented on, you said you've made some connections and friendships among the faculty, and you're still in touch with some of them and still keeping up friendships?
Yeah, there are some students in my class. In particular, I really like music, and in my class there happened to be an amazing Baroque German organist, or he plays German organ music, and he's actually was doing the program in the summer so that he could go study abroad in Germany now, where he is. And I just happened to, we were both friends, and we happened to also be friends with someone who's very interested in German opera. And so, yeah, we've stayed in touch. We meet up. We've just met up a few times, but we get together. We still keep the language pledge. And, you know, we talk about everything from politics and current events to opera, you know, and much more felicitous kind of things.
Oh, that's wonderful. And do you have a favorite moment that you remember, a favorite something that happened this past summer? If you don't.
So I have maybe two. And one is just my classes were amazing. And I love grammar, and I'm usually somebody who's very invested in grammar classes and things like that, but I obviously love literature too. And it was just so much fun to have to, I mean, you know, to make our presentations and things like that for the literature class. I learned so much about a literary tradition that I'd only read in translation before, but I also discovered so many new, you know, artists and philosophers and, you know, German literary figures. And so I did a big presentation on art, and I think that was one of my favorite experiences, along with some poetry, a different presentation on poetry. But the other thing that I think I was just so impressed by was the theater production. And I just thought it was really amazing to see that in such a short amount of time, all of these students came together to do a theatrical representation that was just great. And I mean, yeah, I was blown away by it. I thought it was amazing that they did it together, that they did it on Zoom, you know, and yeah, obviously it was in German, and also introducing us to a great work of theater in and of itself. So I'd say those were probably two of the main things.
Yeah. And you were in a very, I don't want to say this in a, you know, I'm just amazed, you know, you read this literature and the plays and discussed art and wrote a paper on art, and you were in level 1.5, but you still apparently got exposed to some literature and, you know, got to understand it. And
yeah, well, I think that's, for one, a testament to, we had a really great teacher, and she made the literature very accessible to all of us. It was hard, it was challenging, but you know, it's literature, so the more time you spend with it, the easier it becomes.
And one last question. So how did the German immersion program benefit you personally in terms of your academic professional career?
Well, it benefited me in every possible way. I've love German for a really long time, and I work primarily on medieval and Renaissance literature, and those have such a strong traditions of critical commentary has been written in German, and also obviously German medieval and Renaissance literature is incredibly important too. So it was great to be able to just, you know, go deeper into the language and literature and, you know, acquire more skills. I've always wanted to, but up to this point, I've always been prioritizing Romance languages. I did a little bit of Yiddish, and that was just for fun. So it was great to do, you know, kind of another type of literary tradition. So that really helped professionally. And I mean, I plan to continue with German. So it definitely was a huge help.